welcome. You are logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for global Indians. We broadcast news from India, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Punjabi and Gujarati languages. And our portal and apps have a list of well-established businesses and resources that every global Indian needs. I am Drashti and today's headlines are: in India, Mary Kom has become the first woman boxer to bag 6 world championship titles. And at least 30 have died after a bus fell into a canal in Karnataka. In Punjab, DISI is making its presence felt during Indian Sikh Jatha visit to Pakistan, and PM Narendra Modi has hailed the Kartarpur corridor as a bridge between two countries. In Canada, the House has passed back-to-work legislation to end the Canada Post strike, and the Ford government has backtracked on French francophones. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, Canada and Punjab. For detailed news and businesses updates of the Indo-Canadian community, download the Indian Times Daily app. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: MC Mary Kom has become the most successful boxer in the history of women's world championships by winning her 6th gold medal with a unanimous 5-0 result over Ukraine's Hena Okhota in the 48kg category. She now has an incredible 6 gold and 1 silver in the tournament. She dedicated her feat to India. At least 30 people, including 5 children, have been killed and 4 rescued after a bus fell into a canal in South Karnataka. Around 35 people were travelling in the private bus. The bus fell into the canal after the driver lost control. PM Narendra Modi condoled the deaths. Finer details emerging on restructuring of the 13.50 lakh strong army indicate that the force's strength is likely to be brought down by 1 lakh. The downsizing includes cutting down the authorised number of officers by around 4,500. Due to several automated defence operations, most modern armies have been going in for the right sizing. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has hit out at the Congress days after its leader, Raj Babbar, compared the rupee slide with the age of his mother. He stated that those who did not have issues to talk about resorted to abusing someone else's mother. The Uttarakhand government has dedicated to rename the Dehradun Airport after former PM Atal Bihari Vajpayee. The proposal to rename the Jolly Grant Airport after Vajpayee was approved by the state cabinet at a meeting chaired by CM Trivendra Singh Rawat. The SIT probing the killing of journalist activist Gauri Lankesh has named Hindu right-wing outfit Sanatan Sanstha in its additional charge sheet filed before a court. The charge sheet stated that the network within Sanatan Sanstha targeted Lankesh for no personal reasons and that the plot took place almost after 5 years. Delhi's ruling Aam Aadmi Party has criticised the centre after it denied Health Minister Satyendra Jain permission to travel to Australia. Jain was to visit Australia on the invitation of the University of Melbourne and George Institute in Sydney for a dialogue on Mohalla Clinics and Health Revolution of Delhi with the Victorian government. Cash-starved private carrier Jet Airways has temporarily suspended its complimentary lounge services to Jet Privilege Platinum and Gold members travelling in economy class. The airline is battling high operations costs due to increased jet fuel prices and falling rupee. Debit or credit cards using old features with magnetic stripe cards will not be valid from January 1st. Banks are now issuing ATM cards with enhanced features such as EMV chip and PIN-based cards. The additional security feature makes frauds difficult. Shekhar Suman has made a scandalous revelation about Indian Movie Awards or Bollywood Awards. The veteran actor claimed that buying and selling of awards is a common practice in the industry. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from Punjab and Canada follows.
I was living my dream and had a happy life. One day, everything changed. I was overwhelmed with chronic pain and depression. And I was struggling to get my disability benefits. All I wanted was the assurance of my insurance company that I would get paid. But they didn't.
We decided to approach a trusted law firm in the community. Thanks to Kotek Law. Not only did I get my long-term disability settlement in no time, I got my confidence back to carry on with life, too.
We are your trusted disability lawyers at Kotek Law. We will fight to ensure that you get the benefits you deserve.
Welcome back to Indian Times Daily, the top 10 headlines from Punjab are: the wide publicity given to Referendum 2020 campaign at the birth anniversary celebrations of Guru Nanak in Pakistan carries a clear imprint of the ISI. Pakistan is propagating secessionist agenda as a part of its objective to support Referendum 2020, codenamed Operation Express. PM Narendra Modi has said that the proposed Kartarpur corridor can serve as a bridge for people-to-people contact. Modi emphasized that the tragic incidents of 1947 should be left behind, with a new chapter of ties will open between India and Pakistan. An NRI has allegedly murdered his 45-year-old wife with a sharp-edged weapon before committing suicide in Moga. Gurmail Singh had consumed poison and ended his life. He was staying at his wife's parental home when the incident took place. The police have arrested the main perpetrator of the Amritsar grenade attack. The police have cracked the case less than a week after the incident took place at Nirankari Bhavan. The blast had claimed 3 lives and left 16 injured. Pakistan Foreign Minister has announced that the Kartarpur corridor will be opened in 2019 on the 550th birth anniversary of Baba Nanak. Kartarpur is a small town in Narowal, just 4 km away from the Pakistan-India border, where Guru Nanak spent the last 18 years of his life. The police have launched a massive search operation at Shadipur village of Pathankot district after a local claimed to have spotted 6 suspicious men. The search operation was carried out after a farmer saw 6 men carrying backpacks. Food and Civil Supplies Minister Bharat Bhushan Ashu has detected bogus purchase to the tune of 86,000 bags of paddy worth Rs 5.6 crore. Ashu claimed that the fraud came to fore after movement of paddy from other states to Punjab. The state is ready to contribute towards setting up the Kartarpur corridor. CM Amrinder Singh made the announcement during the launch of year-long celebrations to mark the 550th birth anniversary of Guru Nanak Dev. The Agriculture Department has launched a statewide campaign to motivate farmers to adopt proper methods of spraying herbicides with the help of high-tech machines. The move has been taken to ensure efficient control of weeds at an early stage. Former Indian cricket team captain Kapil Dev has presented his book on Sikhism to CM Amrinder Singh, former PM Manmohan Singh and Governor V.P. Badnor. The book is titled We, the Sikhs Around the World. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Canada follows.
The one-stop shop for all insurance solutions. Call Manish Patel at 416-560-1537. Manish Patel for insurance. 416-560-1537.
Welcome back to IndianTimesDaily.com. The top 10 headlines from Canada are: MPs have passed back-to-work legislation to end the Canada Post strike after a late-night debate in the House of Commons and a stage walkout by New Democrats. Bill C-89, the Postal Services Resumption and Continuation Act, passed by a vote of 166-43 early morning. After facing backlash, Premier Doug Ford's government will take steps to bolster the French language in Ontario, but will still cut funding for a planned French university. In its fall economic statement, the government announced the plans to eliminate the position of the French Language Services Commissioner. The Liberal government spent $500,000 on outside advisors to come up with a logo name and branding for a new agency that promises to alleviate poverty in developing countries. The 2017 budget announced $300 million towards developing an institution for poverty reduction. The Conservative Party has raised concerns about an arrangement between the Parliamentary Budget Officer and Finance Department. The move will see ministry officials pitching in to determine the cost of election promises in the run-up to the 2019 federal election. The Prime Minister's office said that Brampton East MP Raj Grewal is stepping away from federal politics to deal with the gambling problem. The PMO also said in its statement it was unaware of any investigation by Peel Regional Police into Grewal's situation. Federal NDP leader Jagmeet Singh won't abandon his high-stakes plan to run for a British Columbia seat, even as a prime opportunity presents itself on his home turf Brampton. Singh said that his decision to run in Burnaby South remained clear. Premier of Saskatchewan Scott Moe is on over a week-long visit to India from November 23 to December 1. During the visit, he will be visiting Delhi and Mumbai and hold meeting with key political and business leaders, senior officials and students. Three employees of an Indian-origin jewellery store in Mississauga saved their shop from being robbed by wielding their saber-style swords at masked robbers. The incident took place in broad daylight at Ashok Jewelers. Mexican President Enrique Peña Nieto and PM Justin Trudeau spoke on phone about the November 30 signing at the G20 summit of the new North American trade deal. Peña Nieto is expected to attend the summit in Buenos Aires on November 30, which would be his last day in office. Three more Canadian cases have been confirmed in the current E. coli outbreak associated with the romaine lettuce, bringing the total number of people who have fallen ill in Canada to 22. The outbreak has also sickened more than 30 people in the US. This is the end of News Bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-Canadian businesses and resources, from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Immigration Terminal, the specialist for visitor visa, student visa, business immigration, family sponsorship, work permits, PNP programs, live-in caregivers and LMIA applications. Highly experienced in cases involving criminal or medical admissibility and previously refused or misrepresentation cases. Call 416-675-5666 in Ontario or 778-927-3455 in BC. Email us at info@immigrationterminal.ca. Immigration Terminal, right consultants, right future.
After hosting Deepika Padukone, Alia Bhatt, Ranveer Singh, Akshay Kumar, Amir Khan and Saif Ali Khan and Sara Ali Khan, Karan Johar is all set to take brothers-in-arms Ishan Khattar and Shahid Kapoor. Karan Johar on Thursday shared a picture of himself with the duo and captioned, "Brothers-in-arms." Soon after that, Ishan shared picture with his older half-brother and it seems to be from the same shoot. He wrote, "Your wingman for life." While Shahid shared the same picture too where he wrote, "Baby boy, I always got your back." For the next episode, Karan will host another sibling duo, Janhvi Kapoor and Arjun Kapoor. Giving out details of the episode on Instagram, he said, "The Coffee with Karan sibling episode was so lovely to chat with this hysterical brother-sister duo at Arjun Kapoor and Janhvi Kapoor." Actress Kareena Kapoor Khan recently made her debut as radio jockey and has launched What Women Want with Kareena Kapoor Khan on Ishq 104.8 FM on Tuesday. On reacting to his wife's debut on a show titled What Women Want, Saif Ali Khan said that Kareena needs many things from him and time is one main thing. During the media interaction at the success party of his film Bazaar, Saif Ali Khan was asked about Kareena's debut as RJ, to which he answered,
"I think she's excited, she's enjoying it, you know. They come home and they discuss these issues and the script, and I saw a little bit of it yesterday. And it looks like she's having lots of fun."
Further, when he was asked about what Kareena wants, he replied,
"Many things, I think, but nice emotional things. Time, I think, is the main thing."
Kareena is entering new space with a new radio show titled What Women Want, while Saif is busy shooting for the second season of Sacred Games, which will be aired on Netflix. Rashi Productions will launch four new faces in Bollywood with its next production, Hum Char Friends Bhi Family Hain. In an anticipatory Twitter post, a poster was revealed where four characters were seen dabbing and hiding their face. Later, a trail of posters with character faces was introduced on Wednesday. Helped by Abhishek Dixit, the film will see newcomers Preet Kamani, Anshuman Malhotra, Simran Sharma and Tushar Pandey in the lead roles. Slated for an early 2019 release, the film is the Rashik Banner's 58th production. The movie explores the idea that in today's day and time, where joint families are rarely seen, friends become family too. Producer Suraj Bajadia said in a statement, "Ever since Rashi opened its door, it has been home to many newcomers. We have taken pride in being the first platform many actors, directors, music composers, singers and technicians. We take pride in introducing four more new faces in main roles to silver screen." Actress Kubra Sai, who rose to fame with her character as Cuckoo in Netflix's first Indian original series Sacred Games, tried hard to change his tag from anchor to actor. Kubra interacted to the media during a fashion event where she anchored Ace Designer's preview of the collections. While talking about the shooting of Sacred Games Season 2, she said,
"Shooting shuru ho chuki hai. To pehle to wo likha ja raha tha, second season. Ab usse likh diya gaya hai aur production is on the floor. Aur direction chalu hai and they're going to be traveling to different places, kahani aage badhegi aur जो सस्पेंस है वो फाइनली रिवील होगा एट द एंड ऑफ सेकंड सीजन.
द 25 ईयर ओल्ड एक्ट्रेस हैज मेड कैमियो एपीयरेंसेस इन वेरियस मूवीज लाइक सुल्तान, रेडी एंड सिटी ऑफ लाइफ, बट इट वाज हर रोल ऑफ अ ट्रांसजेंडर नेम्ड कुकू इन सेक्रेड गेम्स व्हिच हैज गार्नर्ड अ ह्यूज फैन फॉलोइंग. ऑन फर्दर इंटरेक्शन कुब्रा सेड,
आई थिंक मेरे लिए एक्टिंग बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. मैं हमेशा कहती थी ये मैं जो टैग है ना एंकर और फिर एक्टर उसे कैसे चेंज करूं, मैं हमेशा उसके लिए स्ट्राइव करती थी. और अब जब ये हुआ है मुझे वो कहते हैं ना वो चस्का, हाँ तो वो लग गया है. तो अब मुझे एक्टिंग और करनी है.
टॉकिंग अबाउट अपकमिंग प्रोजेक्ट्स, शी सेड
आई एम वर्किंग ऑन टू फिल्म्स, आई एम वर्किंग ऑन अनदर वेब सीरीज, आई एम वर्किंग ऑन अ ट्रैवल शो. So there's a lot going on and it's just super exciting.
Kubra will next be seen in a Voot web series titled Law and Honor and in Zoya Akhtar's upcoming directorial Gully Boy. Actors Kareena Kapoor Khan, Abhishek Bachchan, Madhuri Dixit Nene, Anil Kapoor and Jackie Shroff will lend their voices to characters of Netflix Mowgli, Legend of the Jungle for its Hindi dubbed version. Netflix announced the names of the Indian actors involved with the project in a statement on Tuesday. Abhishek will lend his voice for Bagheera, Kareena will be infusing life to the soft and hypnotic voice of the python Ka, Anil will be giving voice to the free-spirited bear Ballu, Madhuri to Nisha and Jackie to Sher Khan. The actors took to Twitter and expressed their excitement. Abhishek wrote, "So happy to be a part of a story I have loved all my life. He is ready to do whatever it takes to keep Mowgli alive. Wait for Bagheera in Mowgli Legend of the Jungle." Madhuri tweeted, "Ferocious when provoked, especially when it comes to her man cub. Nisha brings the motherly instinct alive in Mowgli Legend of the Jungle. So excited to be the voice behind Nisha." Anil Kapoor wrote, "Bringing the bear necessities to Mowgli Legend of the Jungle as Ballu, a tenacious mentor." Jackie Shroff wrote, "Was an absolute privilege and total blast to dub for this character. I am Sher Khan, Mowgli Legend of the Jungle." Directed by Circus, Mowgli Legend of the Jungle will premiere globally on Netflix on 7 December.